Hey guys, welcome back to Naughty Threats. In case you are new here on my channel, do subscribe and hit the bell icon to get all the future updates. So in today's video, we learn how to work this kind of bridal design. Now, this each design has like three steps and set of three arches. If you want to make this design a little more grand, you can stick some stone chain or pearl chain to it along with a piece of ball chain. So that becomes a really heavy bridal design, but I just wanted to keep it simple. So I'm just showing you guys how to work this design with beads. So you can make any kind of changes as per your requirement. So it's a very interesting design. So watch the video till the end and let me know in the comment section what you think about this design. Now let's get started. For today's design, I am using 6 strands of silk thread and crochet hook number 10. I'm showing it on a sample fabric, and just in case you guys have missed these designs, I'm going to link them in the I button and you can check it out. So I'm going to start off with the right side of this material facing towards me so that the knot gets fixed on the wrong side. So for this design, we will be needing a base. So I'll be working a base. How we do that is after we fix the knot, work one chain and one single crochet. So this step you will have to do from one end of the pallu to the other end. So just one chain and one single crochet. However, this step is optional, but I feel working this step will make the design look little neater compared to when you don't work the base. So it might take a little time, but the finishing comes out really well. So if you ask me, it is better to do the base. Just one chain and one single crochet. This is how you will do till the other end of the pallu. I finished working the baseline and I have trimmed my thread. You will have to trim it once you reach the other end of the pallu. So this part I am going to knot it so that I can start my second line from the same side. So I'll just make one knot and later I'm going to trim off the extra thread. So I have my second color ready with 6 strands here. I've already made a knot. And in this step, I will be using these kind of beads. They are kuchu beads, just round bead with a ring like this. So I'll start off in the same point from where I started my base. And then in this first gap of one chain, I'm going to work one single crochet. So for this particular design, there will be kuchu or tassel. So for that, I'm going to work a chain block, but right before and after the tassel, I want to add this small bead. So I'm going to push the bead and lock it with a chain stitch. So this is how it's going to sit, and then I'm going to work 3 chains. This is the place for the tassel. I have worked a single crochet before I added this bead in the first block of one chain. Now after working 3 chains, I'm going to add another bead. Lock it with a chain stitch. So I'm going to skip 1 and 2, 2 blocks of one chain, and in the third one I'm going to work a single crochet. So this is how it looks, and once we are done with the crochet part, we will be adding a kuchu here in between these two beads. Now I'm going to work 3 chains again and just skip 1. Here is the single crochet. I'm going to skip this, and in this one I'm going to work 1 single crochet. Next I will work 4 chains. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here I'm going to skip 2 and work 1 single crochet in the next one. Again 4 chains. but this time I'm going to turn the fabric and work one single crochet inside this single crochet. So this forms a loop like this. Now after working two chains, I will turn the fabric back. So when I'm working my double crochets, the right side is towards me. Now in this loop of four chains, if you want, you can actually work inside both. I think that's what we'll do. You can hold both these together and work 10 double crochets. So after 10 double crochets, this is how it looks, and here is my single crochet which I worked in the previous row. So after this I'm going to skip one block, and in the next block I'm going to work a single crochet and then chain 6, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So once I have 6 chains on my hook, I'm going to turn my work, and from my left side I'm going to count 1, 2, 3 and insert this in the fourth stitch. So this is the loop where we'll be working our second arch. So before I start working my double crochets, chain 2, turn the work again, and here we'll work around 14 to 15 double crochets. This is my 15th stitch. So after 15 double crochets, again I'm going to skip one block, and in the next block I'll work a single crochet. So far this is how it looks. Now this time I'm going to work 8 chains, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Again turn the fabric, count fourth stitch from the top, so 1, 2, 3 and 4. In the fourth stitch we will be working a single crochet, chain 2 and turn. Now in this 8 chains, easily around 18 double crochets can squeeze in, but I'm going to add beads in this step. So after every double crochet I will be adding one small bead. So after my first double crochet, I'll pull a long loop and insert a bead, then continue with my second double crochet. If you don't want to add bead in this step, you can simply work double crochets continuously one after the other. Now because I'm adding a bead after every double crochet, I might have to work a little lesser double crochets. In case you are working only double crochets without bead, then the stitch count might vary a little.
So I have worked 11 double crochets and I have added 10 beads. So if I try to squeeze in few more beads, then this arch might not be flat. Instead, it will tend to have some waves. So I think I'll stop it here. Skip one, and in the next one, I'm going to do a single crochet to fix this. So this completes one design. So same way we will continue. After finishing, this is how it looks. I've made a little correction to this part here. So we have started off with this block of chains to add a tassel, after which there is an empty block. So I've continued the same. I've worked one empty block before the tassel block and after the tassel block, so that the tassel falls in the center and there are two empty blocks on either sides. So same way you will continue. Now I'm adding this color tassel to it. I'm just tying it like I always do, using two strands of zari thread. Once I add the tassel, I will show you guys the final look. After adding tassels, this is how it is looking. I think these beads are really looking cute next to the tassel. This is the first time I am using these kind of beads for a crochet design. So in case you want these, you can order them on naughtythreads.com. If you want this part to be colorful, you can trim off once you're done here and then join another color and continue that way. And base can be in a completely different color. Same goes with the tassel. So that's how you can make the design colorful. Since I'm just working a pattern here, I wanted to finish off in single color. And I think I already mentioned adding beads in this step is completely optional. If you don't want, you can just skip beads and increase the number of double crochets. So this is how the design has come out. I really like it. It looks different and trendy. So do give it a try, and if you happen to try, share the pictures on our Facebook group, which is called the Crochet Club by Naughty Threads. Sorry. So yeah, I guess that's all in today's video. Do let me know what you think about this design in the comment section below. Don't forget to check out my blog, naughtythreads.net. And in case you guys have not subscribed to my vlog channel, that is Kanika Reddy Vlogs, do subscribe. And whoever is watching the video without subscribing to our channel, please subscribe and do share it with your friends. So I shall see you guys soon with more interesting stuff. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.